Hello, this is your midday news from our Vox Africa studios here in London. I am Pamela Bonkiong, still in Mali. French and Malian troops are welcomed with cheers by the people of Timbuktu after their town is liberated. Chants of Vive la France and gratitude towards the former colonial master are now arrive in Gao and Timbuktu following their liberation. As the joint forces move towards Kidal, the town has been confirmed retaken by the MNLA Tuareg rebels who, a week ago, decided to join forces with international efforts to liberate Mali of jihadists. International donors are attending our conference in Ethiopia to pledge financial and logistical support for Mali. This is in an effort to dislodge al-Qaeda allied militants in the region. The president of the Economic Community of West African States, ECOWAS, stressed the importance of securing logistical and financial resources before embarking on a mission such as that in Mali. The African Union has condemned the situation in Mali as terrorism. Ban Ki-moon notes that military intervention in Mali was inevitable.
The military operation is inevitable. And that is why all African Union and Western powers, they are supporting. The United Nations is now actively considering, through my recommendation to the Security Council, how United Nations can help with those African countries in terms of logistical support.
When it comes to the approach, whether certain crises should be addressed by military means or political processes, I don't think it is not only me. All the world leaders agree that political process should prevail. And all the pending issues, all the crises or difference of views should be resolved peacefully through dialogue.
Nigerian troops are streaming into Mali to reinforce the Malian forces available on the ground. A convoy made up of more than 100 tanks and trucks carrying French and Nigerian forces entered Malian territory yesterday. They crossed the border into the town of Ayoro, where they will then make their way into Gao. Ayoro is a Malian town located 234 kilometers from Gao, and many do not speak out here for fear of reprisals. The additional troops, it is hoped, will help restore calm and integrity to Malian territories. In the meantime, a Malian entrepreneur has accused the Malian army of destroying his business premises in Bamako. Old Khalifa, who runs a bus company, said his staff was intimidated and his offices ransacked, while property was also destroyed. Mali's military has responded by denying these accusations. Lieutenant Colonel Seydou Sogolba said the military had been given clear instructions to not extort anything from the civil population. Colonel Sogolba believes these are the orders they should be following. Khalifa, the director general of the bus company Sonef, said the people who attacked his officers were wearing military uniforms and had ammunition on them.
We do have images, we do have evidence, and we have about 300 or 400 people around the company who was there that day, and they all saw those people. They were dressed in a military uniform, they were armed, they had a kalash, and so they came in military cars. So I think it's obvious that it's them. There is a lot of problem going on here in Bamako. A lot of family has been attacked, a person has been aggressed, and they always take cars, they take money, they take everything because they don't have any evidence against you. So all that, what they can do is taking all what you have and leave you like that. They cannot take you to the jail. They don't have any evidence. There is no justice. Just.
After experiencing relative peace in the past couple of weeks, Mogadishu is the center of a suicide bomb attack. A suicide bomber blew himself up near the Somali presidential palace earlier today, killing at least two soldiers. The strike was aimed at the country's leaders, a palace guard at the scene said. Officials working in the palace and guard said Somali President Hassan Sheikh Mohamud was abroad at the time of the blast, and Prime Minister Abdi Farah Sheridan, whose house was near the site of the explosion, is reported to be safe. Young people in Egypt have become the main participants in the continued riots. Over the recent years, domestic unrest has lasted for 2 years. Within those 2 years, our security has been threatened due to the gloomy economy, and the unemployment rate has risen dramatically, both contributing to young people's participation in riots. People under 25 years old account for half of the country's population. It is reported that in the last 2 years, 98% of the dead in domestic riots were under 30 years old. Still, many political forces pay the youth to join in different protests. According to Bashir Abdel Fattah, the chief of Democracy magazine, the youth need an outlet through which they can express themselves.
Turkel chance for them to improve themselves through demonstrations and through asking for new demands for them, for political participation, for their chances in power. I think he have the will to do that, but the ability, this is a problem. He might not have a vision, he might not have a program for that.
In the Egyptian port city of Port Said yesterday, thousands joined funerals for the latest victims of clashes. 7 people were killed in Port Said on Sunday when residents joined marches to bury 33 others who had been killed earlier, most of them by gunshot wounds in a city where arms are now rife. Protests erupted on Saturday after a court sentenced to death several people from the city for their role in deadly soccer violence last year, a verdict residents saw as unfair. The anger swiftly turned against Morsi and his government. The Lebanese city of Beirut has been rocked by another bomb blast, fortunately without any casualties. A bomb planted under a car exploded in a southern suburb of Beirut late on Monday, according to a Lebanese security source. The bomb blast was in a Shiite Muslim area that is a stronghold of the militant group Hezbollah. The bomb destroyed the car and damaged buildings in the residential area of Hay al-Salem, but there were no casualties. France's National Assembly is today said to begin debating on a controversial bill to legalize gay marriage. Though the decision has started protests in France, the measure is approved by a majority of the population, according to opinion polls. The two-week debate at the French Parliament about the planned law change will be one of the biggest social reforms since the abolition of the death penalty in 1981. Queen Beatrix of the Netherlands has announced she is abdicating in favour of her son, Prince Willem-Alexander. In a pre-recorded address broadcast on TV, she said she would formally stand down on the 30th of April. The Queen, who is approaching her 75th birthday, said she had been thinking about this moment for several years and that now was the moment to lay down my crown. Queen Beatrix has been head of state since 1980 when her mother abdicated. Following a fire at a nightclub in Brazil which killed 233 people, the club owners and the band playing that night have been detained by authorities. The people of the town of Santa Maria buried 80 of the dead yesterday. In an address, Brazilian President Dilma Rousseff said that a commitment should be established to ensure this tragedy does not happen again. She talked about the unfulfilled dreams of the victims, saying there could have been future mayors, but were robbed of that opportunity. Ghana is through to the quarterfinals of the African Cup of Nations by beating Niger to finish top of Group B. Captain Assamah Ogien was instrumental throughout and he set the Black Stars on their way when he controlled Albert Adoma's cross and they drove home. It was a comprehensive victory and a solid performance from a Ghana team that went into the game knowing they only needed a draw to make it to the last 8. The last time Ghana won the African Cup of Nations was in 1982. A win this time will break a 31-year hiatus.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Ghana's Black Stars remain hopeful and are looking forward to the finals.
Congratulations, you won by 3-0. How do you feel about winning this game?
It's very important for us, you know, because we want to win the group, to be first, so that we stay here, because here is like our home ground now. We know the field, we know the people here, and we feel very, very comfortable here. So we are very, very happy to win this game today.
Now, you came in from the bench. From where you sat, could you think we could win the game?
Yeah, I know we're going to win the game. We're going to do everything to win the game, because this game is very, very important for us. Like I said to you before, we want to be first in the group, and we did it, and we really, really give thanks to God.
Now, you're coming up against Cape Verde, which, to an extent, is not a bigger side. How are you approaching that game?
We know it's going to be a very tough game as well. We play against them before this tournament starts, a friendly match in Portugal. They play very good football. They play very disciplined football, and they are very, very good when they have the ball. So, you know, we go into training tomorrow, learn our mistakes, and make sure that, you know, we'll be very ready for them, and we'll be in the right channel for them. Thank you.
Well, I will give thanks to Almighty God for the victory. You know, it's not easy, but we came in strongly to beat them. It's very convenient. We had 3 goals.
Now, what does it mean to you? Now you're moving to the quarterfinals and playing Cape Verde in the next match. How are you approaching this game?
You know, in this tournament, every country came to the tournament with strong, mentality. You understand? So we need to go all out. If only we want to win the cup, we need to go out. And then, you know, Cape Verde are a very good side. So we need to prepare very hard, more than what we did today, so that we can beat them.
Congratulations, sir.
Well, for more of updates on the AFCON matches, tune on to our 360, Sports 360 program, only on Mondays, Wednesdays and Saturday at 8 p.m. Thank you for watching. Stay tuned to Vox Africa, and we shall see you in a moment.